Minds are the minds of medicine. This is their story.
The American Cancer Society predicts that over 50,000 people will be diagnosed with pancreatic cancer this year. And while treatment is improving, the one-year survival rate for all stages of this type of cancer is 20%. The grim diagnosis of pancreatic cancer led Scott Hirschey thousands of miles away for cancer surgery, but his cancer returned. Now, he arrives at Henry Ford Hospital in need of a better solution.
Scott was diagnosed with pancreatic cancer in August of 2012. And when you get a diagnosis like that, it's like you get hit by a Mack truck, literally.
Shocked. Very, very shocked. So far, I had a good run for about 4 years, and then the pancreatic cancer came back.
With a return of his pancreatic cancer, Scott Hirschey faced an uncertain future. Did he have the strength to go through weeks of additional radiation? And would it even work? He turned to the cancer team with the Josephine Ford Cancer Institute. As nationally recognized leaders in cancer surgery, radiation oncology, medical oncology research, and all types of cancer, they provided him a solution that they were first in North America to offer.
In terms of the stereotactic or focused radiation, we've been doing that here at Henry Ford for well over a decade. We're one of the pioneers in that type of technology. But we were really excited and proud to be the first in North America, the second in the world, to actually have this brand new edge stereotactic dedicated technology. That's really been a highlight in terms of being able to even treat our patients that much more accurately, that much more rapidly, in a completely integrated fashion. This option of the stereotactic radiation completely changes all the previous rules, because in the past we would be very concerned about re-irradiating somebody. To give more radiation to the same area becomes a real challenge because of the side effects and the concern about the added radiation. But if you can imagine doing that re-irradiation in such a focused way that it's literally just around the tumor and you're barely touching any of the normal tissue around it, well, now all of a sudden you have a new exciting option where you can apply that approach.
The cancer team at Henry Ford offered Scott a combination of expertise, technology, and patient care unlike any other hospital in the country. This included the use of the most advanced radiosurgery available, a completely noninvasive approach that uses a combination of imaging and multiple beams of radiation to spare Scott's normal tissue and kill the cancer. This gave him a fighting chance at beating pancreatic cancer a second time.
At the heart of these techniques is precisely and accurately delivering high doses of radiation, often in 1 to 5 treatments, to a well-visualized tumor. It may be moving, it may be stable. Immobilizing patients in a very precise and reproducible manner.
He's had 2 different kinds of radiation. The first one was 28 days, second time was 5. And what a big difference that is to go 5 times instead of for 5.5 weeks.
For the second round cancer, and Dr. Azzolini, he did the radiation on me, and it's excellent equipment he has.
Well, imagine being a patient, and not only are you understandably concerned, you've just heard about the diagnosis of cancer, but now a doctor's telling you, I want you to lie flat on this table still for, you know, over an hour, don't move. It's a bit overwhelming and a little nerve-wracking. If instead we can tell that same patient, you know what, we can do this in about 15 minutes and we'll keep you in this position, breathe normally, everything's going to be fine, it's a much more comforting and relaxing approach.
With the careful coordination of a team of radiation oncologists, technologists, physicists, and nurses, Scott's tumor shrunk after just 5 treatments. It's coordination and advancements like these that have put the Josephine Ford Cancer Institute in the top 1% nationally in patient satisfaction.
It's like with any technology, you go through steps, you know, small steps, and then it keeps on improving. So I'm anxious to wait what the next one will look like.
I mean, looking for that next innovative leap, I think, runs in our blood, right? We're Henry Ford Health System. Looking for ways that we can innovate and stay a step ahead is part of who we are. And so that was one of the strongest draws for our program. I mean, we just recently finished a course where we taught people from all over the country, and actually from international students even, in how to offer stereotactic radiotherapy.
Through specialized technology and coordinated care, Henry Ford's cancer team is treating patients with all types of tumors from around the country, including pancreatic cancer patients like Scott Hirschey.
You know, we've had a lot of fun times, we've had a lot of laughs, we've grown closer together, we've met some wonderful people along the way, and life is good. All in all, life is good.
You have to think positive and listen to medical teams. It works. They pulled me through the first time, and I plan on doing it again.
To learn more about Josephine Ford Cancer Institute's nationally recognized surgeons, radiation oncologists, medical oncologists, researchers, and other specialists, go to henryford.com/cancer.